Okay, coaches, we've seen the right hand, we've seen the jab, and we've seen both of them put into motion. Now what we want to take a look at is the left hook. And you as a coach have to be very diligent again in how to throw this left hook. Anybody can throw it, and you've got to offer a target that's realistic. I'm going to ask Dave to come back in here again. David, we've done the jab, we've done the right hand, your footwork is good, your upper body movement is fine. Now, the left hook is going to be kind of difficult for me to show you what to do if he doesn't set it up with the previous punches. You're not basically going to get up there and just stick your hand out and just let him throw one shot after the other. I prefer it when you put the shots together. Although there are some fighters who can get away with an explosive lead right hand like Roy, not everybody is like Roy, and it's not something that you're likely to do is to lead a left hook. If you're hitting anybody with a left hook, the guy you're hitting with the left hook shouldn't be in there with you, because it's very rare you're going to get hit with a lead left hook, especially from long range and especially if you've got a good base and a good foundation. So what we want to do is try to now incorporate the other punches that we've seen so far, which is the jab and right hand, and follow it up with the left hook. Then I'll show you how you can get your boxer to practice throwing the left hook without actually throwing the other punches. So right now what I would want Dave to do is just set it up. Now he's got his base good, his feet are nice and apart, his hands are ready. So he's got the jab, now the right hand will come around. One, two, boom, there's a three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Now notice how David turns the hook over and lands it with the knuckles of his glove. This is why sometimes, and you know, you might see some coaches saying they don't like their fighters to be wearing the gloves that have no padding on the thumb. I'm not against that. I don't mind it, because what it does is it keeps a boxer very alert and very sharp that he has to make contact with the knuckle portion of the glove. You don't want him developing the habit where he throws the hook and kind of throws it inside with the elbow down a little bit and starts slapping the shot. And when you're wearing the big gloves, you have a tendency to cheat that way. If you're not, you want to make sure you turn it over and land with the knuckle portion of the glove. So let's take a look at that again there, David. We'll put down a one, two, boom, and the three comes around, boom. Boom. Good. Now we can show it the other way as well. David was throwing it now with the thumb turned this way. Now we can show it with the thumb thrown up. Again, you're hiding the thumb from the opponent, and you're landing with the knuckle portion of the glove. So let's take a look at it again. And again. And again. Good. Now back to the jab, and we go back to setting it up again. One, two, three. One, two, three. And now with the thumb down. And again, bring it around. Now you see David's, again, I'm going to stop David now because he's making the mistake. He's letting the hand get in front of his body. So make sure you turn around. There it is. There it is. Bring the punch from behind. Sometimes what I like to show the fighters to do is put the hand out there. Exaggerate it. Now turn the body. There it is. Turn the body. Boom. And just by snapping the shoulder, you're going to get the power you need. And that'll develop. At first, it might not feel strong. Don't be worried about that. Those muscles will develop and it will get stronger. Coaches, make sure technically they do it right. If they do it right, it will get stronger time and time again. Don't look for the magical power. It has to develop. Again, we'll go back through it. One, two, boom, the hook. Boom. Now notice how the first two are limited impact. They're just basically designed punches just to be fast, quick, to the point in order to set up the power shot, which is the left hook. Again, David comes off. One, two, boom, left hook. Boom, left hook. Now, what I like to do after that, of course, is go back with the body shot. That's a favorite of mine, and it's Dave's favorite punch as well. We use the first three to set up the shot and then go down to the body. You want your opponent thinking you're going to the head, and then you want to crack him with a good, strong body shot right into the liver. Do it again, David. Boom. Now, David's making a mistake here because he's dropping that right hand, so I'm going to stop him. I'm not just going to say, yeah, the left hook is good, because that's not your job as a coach. Coaches, remember, the boxer needs you to teach him. He wants you to show him. If he is making a mistake, he's counting on you to give it to him, to give him that advice to fix it. So make sure if he does something wrong that he does fix it. So David, make sure you keep that right hand where it should be after when you're throwing the one to the body. Boom. There it is. Now do it again. Put it in full speed. Boom. And again. Boom. That's it. Boom. There it is. And he's putting it right down into the body. Boom. There it is. Good. Again, we'll go back to the jab. We'll go back to the jab. I'll throw just to make sure, keeping David awake. I'm just going to want to throw the shots back at him so he can block the shots. And we'll do it again. One, two, three, and boom. And we'll do it again. One, two, three, and boom. And we'll do one, two, three. Boom. There it is. And we'll pop him. That's it. Again, pay attention. Now, you're not just because you're working the left hook doesn't mean that you're not concentrating on the other things as well. You as the coach have to be observant to all this. So when I see David move, I want to make sure that his feet are good. I want to make sure his balance is good. That's it. Here it is. Boom. There's the left hook to the body. Boom. Good. Now I want to show him about blocking the shot. There. He'll block that one. Boom. He'll block that one. I'll throw a right hand, left hook after him. He'll block it. Hup, hup. And he'll block it. Hup, hup. Perfect. Just like that. And those are the things you want to look at when you're working on the left hook. The other thing we want to look at is the combinations with those punches. Now, the combinations on those punches are limitless. You can do endless number of things with those. And as the fighter develops and he's mastered each punch individually, you can start putting it together. None of this would be able to be put together again, and I repeat this, if the base wasn't good. That is the most important. The base and the stance is the most important with the footwork in order to be able to put those shots together. Once the fighter's mastered the individual punches, it'll be quite easy for him to put together the combination. So, David, take your position. Now, there's David's boxing position. Now, we're going to just simulate that this is the first round going. Go back to your corner, David, and we'll just simulate that. Ding, the bell rings. So David comes out to meet the coach as if he's coming out to meet the opponent. And always, coaches, instill this in your fighters. When they come out as if you're coming out to meet the most dangerous man in the world. Because everybody, all good fighters, forget about the guys that are not good, but all good fighters are dangerous, especially early. So come out with a respect for your opponent and be careful. And that's the way you want him coming out to you, coach, on the mitts as well. So ding, the bell rings, David comes out. Now the hands are high and he's paying attention to what he's doing. Smooth, take his time, move. Don't rush the issue. Put the combinations up and let him throw. Boom, back to the jab, bang, right there. Bang, that's it. Simulate the fight scene. Simulate what's going to happen. Bang, good. David's moving his head as if the punches are coming at him. Pop, he's popping them out. Boom, good. Reach for that. See, that would have been my fault as a coach for not having the target there for him. Boom, pop, pop, pop. Good. Now we'll do a little bit inside. And boom, there's the uppercut. That was the one we didn't work on. And that's the kind of shot you'll throw on the inside. And that's where you can simulate exactly what would happen in a fight where the fighter would come inside and David reacted quickly and threw the uppercut underneath. It's quite easy to throw that shot. Good underneath shot. You're on the inside. Again, I'll offer a little offense back so that David makes sure he stays focused and sharp when he's on the inside. Boom. There's the uppercut underneath. And again, boom. Good. Notice how he's turning the hip underneath. Hup. And the left hook under. Hup. And under. And under. Good. And back to the jab. Bang. Again, simulate what's happening. Use your hands, David. That's it. You just hold your hands out there. That's it. So you know. Boom. Good. Good. Use your range now. That's it. Boom. Good. Good. We'll move and we'll put it together. Huh. There's that left hook to the body. Huh. Now the right hand. Let's see that right hand we worked on. Huh. Good. Move. Move. And the right hand. Huh. Good. And the right hand turn. Huh. And now we'll put the right hand left hook together. So I'll ask David to move and just slide over. Right hand. Huh. Huh. Good. And we'll do it again. Huh. Huh. Good. And we'll pop. Keep going. Bang. Now we'll slip the shots. Hup. Right hand, left hook. Slip. Right hand, left hook. And we'll do it again. Hup, hup, hup. And we'll slip. Hup, hup, hup. Good. And we'll go back to the jab. That's it. Hup. That's it. Again, be very careful with what. Keep moving. Keep moving. Don't get complacent. That's right. And one, two, threes. Good. Good speed. And there. Left hook. And left hook. Again, you're on the inside now, so offer the inside target punches. Don't be close to your boxer and expect him to throw long range punches. When you get inside, make sure he throws inside punches. Inside punches consist of the body shots, the little left hooks underneath, the right uppercuts underneath, the right uppercuts to the head, the left uppercuts underneath. Those are the shots you want him throwing on the inside. And then you, as the coach, offer up that target back on the outside. Boom, boom, offer it up. Boom, let him throw it, let him block, let him block. That's it. Then you go back to the outside. Now you can even offer him up some offense from the outside. Make sure David keeps the hands up and he blocks the shots just like he would an opponent. Bang, bang. And he'll counter. Bang, he'll counter. That's right, he'll counter. Good. Good, that's exactly what he'll counter. Boom. Now we'll do another one, another little combination routine that involves all the punches, which is the double going backwards, which is the double jab, uppercut, left hook, right hand, left hook. That pretty much encompasses all the fighters, and that's a favorite combination of a lot of fighters, especially moving backwards. You set your opponent up, boom, and do it again. Good. Turn the hook over, David. Make sure the hook turns over. And again. Good. And back to the jab. That's it. Now we'll do the slips. Slip the jab, right hand, left hook. We'll slip, right hand, left hook. And again, you're waking, you're giving me the target, you're using that range of motion that we spoke of. Slip, right hand, left hook. And we'll slip, and we'll slip, that's it. And we'll slip, that's right. And move again. Now we'll slip the right hand and throw a right hand, left hook counter. So again, base is open, the range of motion is there. David will slip the right hand, left hook, right hand. And we'll slip it again, finish with the left hook. Remember, try to finish with the left hand. Throw it again, that's it. And we'll do it again. Pop, 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 pop. Again, you see how he loaded up on the right hand. Stop him. Correct it. Fix it again. Let's do it again. We'll slip. Good. And we'll do it again. Good. And we'll do it again. Good.